Hey everyone, this is Mel from PMT House of Drums. We're here at PMT Manchester and I have with me the wonderful Ben from Didario UK, the distributors of Meinl, Promark and Evans. And today we are going to be talking about... Hey, I'm Mel from PMT House of Drums. I'm here with Ben from Didario and we're going to talk a little bit about Promark drumsticks.
Yep.
Amongst other Promark products as well, of course.
Definitely.
Like these very, very sexy stick bags that we have here.
Yeah.
But yeah, let's talk about Promark first and foremost.
So Promark, Promark's been going for, I believe, 60 years this year. So it was Evans last year.
Do you want me to
year.
Google that and make sure you're right?
No, I'm pretty sure. 60 years this year. Didario acquired Promark as a brand in 2011.
Okay.
If the maths is correct, what? That's six years ago.
Six years ago.
And in that time, the idea has been to really improve the quality and consistency of the stick.
Yeah.
And basically produce the best pair of sticks that you can buy.
Okay.
So that was the kind of mission of Didario. Obviously, Promark is a prestigious brand. Everybody recognises the two bands around the centre of the stick. So wherever you're at, you can tell it's a Promark stick.
Definitely.
So yeah, a lot of improvements in the manufacturing of the sticks, in the weight sorting of the sticks as well, in the tone matching of the sticks. Ultimately though, it all comes back to the log that the stick is made from.
Sure.
So what Didario did, we actually opened our own sawmill, which actually takes a log from its log form, goes into the side of our sawmill, and then is basically taken through a number of processes to produce the wood that we make into dowels that we produce a stick with.
Okay.
So that's in Tennessee.
Yeah.
The stick finishing sort of facility is in Houston, Texas. So it's all in-house in the US. And obviously, because we've got full control over the natural material, that means that we're producing a lot less waste from the wood that we're using.
So environmentally aware.
Exactly. I mean, the key to a good drumstick is straightest grain possible. Sure. American hickory is kind of the best wood for a medium weight stick. Obviously, we make sticks with maple and we go the other end of the scale with oak as well.
Yeah.
So oak's another famous stick that Promark have produced for years and years.
Sure.
So a lot of these improvements in consistency mean the stick will hopefully last and outlast other brands. Also what we're doing as well is producing sticks with some funky features, and that's kind of what we're going to go through today.
Okay, that's good.
So we'll
inside
do the,
your bag
the,
of tricks,
the grand unveil.
Amazing.
We've got a big selection. Some of the sticks have been out for a number of months now.
Sure.
Some of them have been released at NAMM this year, but all of them are now available to buy from the fine chaps at PMT. So one thing with drumsticks is there's no set rule as to what you should play. And I would highly recommend that you come down, you get some advice from Mel and Pesky, and basically try some out.
Absolutely.
The big thing with sticks though is working out why a stick feels a certain way and why drummers gravitate towards a certain feeling stick.
Sure.
A drumstick that I like, you may not.
Absolutely, it's as unique as we all are, isn't it?
Exactly, so, exactly. One thing we did do a couple of years ago is select balance, which broke down the anatomy of a drumstick. So you take a drumstick, obviously you've got kind of the end that you hold, you know, the butt end of the stick, and you move up to the taper of the stick. Now the taper and the length will make a stick feel completely different from one and another.
Of course, yeah.
So that's always one thing to consider when buying a stick, is how long is the taper of the stick? And that will dictate how forward weighted or how rear weighted the stick will feel. So depending on your style, if you like to dig in and just play, probably a shorter taper stick.
And it's not necessarily down
better.
To the style of music you play or anything like that. It's more about your own
technique
and
build, whatever
exactly,
it is.
Exactly, yeah.
And then obviously the tip part as well. The tip part of a stick is, it's hugely different from stick to stick.
And influential on the sound.
Whatever cymbal sound you want, or say you're playing a jazz pattern, the tip is very important to consider. So, you know, a small ball tip on a drumstick will give you a completely different sound to an oval tip.
Very fine articulation.
Yeah, so you're looking at kind of 6-7 different variations on tips.
Absolutely.
And then they can vary in size as well. So all of those will help or hinder certain players. Mm. However, the models today we're going to talk about, we'll probably stick with these. Excuse the pun. ActiveGrip. Yeah. We brought this out last year.
It's been really popular. We've done really well with it. You know, people coming here asking for it all the time. Mm-hmm. It's not just an aesthetic thing. It works really, really well.
It does.
Tell us a little bit about the process of how.
So the ActiveGrip. In fact, the ActiveGrip did come out the previous. With the Glen Kotche stick, which we will move on to in a bit.
Absolutely.
But we brought it out into the standard sizes. So we took our Select Balance range, which basically picks the most popular size sticks the drummers know.
5A, 5B, 7A, 55s, I think, are in there as
well. Yeah, there was 55s, and then there's two variations on a 5A, so there was two versions of that.
Yeah.
We picked the three most popular from our original Select Balance range and brought them out in ActiveGrip. So ActiveGrip. The big thing with this is it is a lacquer that is heat activated, pH activated, so it's responsive dependent on your body temperature.
Sure.
So unlike dipped sticks, generally you will find that it will be a grip that is dipped on after.
It's like a rubberized kind of solution.
It's like a rubberized solution.
Yeah.
So all our sticks, unless they're stated natural, are lacquered with a clear lacquer.
Sure.
However, there's an ingredient within the ActiveGrip lacquer which is activated by heat and sweat.
And it's not necessarily the fact that they're black or that they're sort of more orangey colour. It's a clear lacquer.
Yeah, so it's water-based as well.
Yeah.
So if we wanted, we could colour these whatever colour we wanted
to.
However, black just allows the customer to distinguish between them.
Absolutely.
So these will respond. Say if you're at a hot, sweaty gig and you're playing away, we've all been there where the stick starts to slip as you get more into it.
You end up down here.
You get down there. Or the other thing is your grip. You end up gripping harder than you need to.
Definitely.
Then you seize up.
Yeah.
And then you go for the last fill and you're like, oh. And that's it.
We've all been
big
there,
finish down the pan. So with ActiveGrip, it allows somebody who wants a bit more traction to still play the stick they used to. So by embedding that ingredient in the lacquer, we're not adding any weight, we're not adding any diameter. So again, if you're putting tape on your sticks, you're going to be adding diameter.
Yeah.
Changes the balance of the stick.
Of course it does,
So it's a really non-intrusive lacquer, I think is probably the best way to put it, that reacts. And it will go back to its normal state when you cool down.
I mean, I've used them a bunch of times, and it's just, as your hand gets warmer, as you're playing, it just, the stick gets tacky, and, you know, you can just feel it sort of staying where you put it, for the most part, so.
That's it. I mean, not everybody needs, some people need ActiveGrip or grip sticks. A lot of people like standard lacquer, but certain drummers sweat more than others. I mean, the Glen Kotche stick, we'll move on to that in a second, but.
You really want to talk about the Glen Kotche stick?
I do. I like that stick, and then we'll see why in a bit.
Absolutely, everybody likes this stick, mate.
But the ActiveGrip sticks in the standard sizes, we basically picked the 5.35, so that's 0.535 of an inch diameter, with a forward or a rebound taper. So the forward taper is 2.25 inches, and that gives you a more forward throwing stick.
Yeah.
And the rebound taper is 3 inches in length. So sticks wise, length is 16 inches, but the taper is what differs, and it's wholly different. You've tried them yourself, and forward versus rebound.
Absolutely,
it's chalk and cheese. So it allows people to pick a diameter that they really, really like.
I think there was a little bit of confusion when they first came out. People were thinking, oh, how did they manage to, you know, because obviously you've got the forward and the rebound. People were like, oh, how did they manage to weight the stick down the bottom end? And it's not about that. I mean, as you just pointed out, it's more to do with the length of the taper.
So the amount of material on that,
exactly,
that fulcrum.
Exactly, nice one. It's good to have that sort of clarified for anyone that's watching. That's how it works.
So yeah, that's it. Six variants on that. 7A, which is 0.535. The 5A, which is 0.565. And then the 5B, so 0.595. So there's small, medium and large, forward and rebound.
Okay.
So six different versions of. You guys have got them all in.
Yeah, absolutely.
So if you do want to come and compare them, come and speak to Mel.
Yeah, we've got a pad and you can literally just try them all out and see which one works best for you. We always kind of try and get people to do that, because sticks are a bit of a mystery, you know, to some people. It's like, oh, what stick do I go for? A lot of people tend to start with the 5A as a standard model, and then over time decide whether they want to go a little thicker, a little bit thinner, whether they want a different type of tip, different variation or whatever. Yeah. But
it can be intimidating, you know.
There's so many models of sticks. There's like key brands, and then within each brand, there's like literally endless amounts of models, so it is daunting. You can come down to any of the stores and try whichever model stick out you want, find the right one in your own time, you know, nice and cash.
So that's our big thing, ActiveGrip. Try those out.
Whilst we're talking about the ActiveGrip thing, shall we move on to the...
We're going to move on. So really all of these now are variants on the ActiveGrip. Yeah. So we move into signature series sticks.
Sure.
So these are really artists that, you know, shout about Promark.
Oh, there they are. the big reveal.
The big reveal. So Glenn Kotche, ActiveWave sticks. We actually had these at London 2 years ago now.
Yeah.
So this was the first version of ActiveGrip, the first time we used it on a stick. So Glenn's stick is fairly
ribbed.
Long. It's fairly long and ribbed. It is indeed.
I don't need to say anything right now.
Plenty grip. So that's the butt end,
yeah,
as they would say in the industry. And his stick, covered in the ActiveGrip coating as well, he sweats quite a lot.
Right.
So he really needed a stick with a bit of traction. But also he changes from traditional grip to, you know, to standard grip, match grip.
Yeah.
So he wanted something that he could really kind of move around with the stick. So you've got the ActiveWave.
Yeah, I mean, it's a very unique feeling stick. But I mean, I've used these a couple of times. Obviously, when they first came out, I was instantly curious because I'd never come across a stick that looked like that. You know, you can get a sort of a bit of a close-up on that, but it's very, very cool. It feels surprisingly natural when you're playing it.
Yes.
Because your fingers tend to just fall exactly where, you know, in the right place, and then when they're there, the balance is kind of perfect. They're a really, really lovely stick to use.
And this would have been difficult to lathe with kind of a blade and a spinning piece of dowel. So since we moved to grinders, this has allowed us to profile sticks in that shape.
Okay.
But keep it nice and smooth as well.
Yeah.
A lot of people like these. We actually had an email from a guy who he had Parkinson's, and he was a drummer all his life, and he found that he couldn't grip his sticks. So the ActiveWave gave him that extra traction.
Excellent.
And actually got him back into playing drums.
Oh, brilliant.
So he was very, very grateful of that. But really, you know, if you want a super secure stick, I think that's probably the boy. Now I'm going to have to reference the length because I've completely forgotten.
That's all right.
But the Kotches are 16 3/4, so they are 3/4 of an inch longer.
Yeah.
So if you do want a bit of extra reach. It doesn't actually look like much, but it makes a whole lot of difference to
definitely.
The feeling of the stick. Other ActiveGrip that's been released that we have here is the Anton Fig.
Nice.
So Anton Fig is Letterman's drummer.
Yeah.
Amongst other things.
He's also, we've just been discussing this, his discography is absolutely huge.
Massive.
He's done everything. I just found out that he even played on a Kiss album.
Kiss album.
Yeah, that's crazy.
B.B. King.
Yeah, I know he played with John Bon Jovi for a while and all kinds of crazy
Joe
stuff.
Joe Bonamassa.
Yeah.
Massive.
Nuts.
But again, this is just signature stick to his spec. So it's 595, big ball tip, same as his other signature stick, pretty much, apart from the grip system has changed. So now we're ActiveGrip instead of ProGrip.
Yeah,
so check those out.
They are big balls.
Yeah, great sticks, massive sound from that tip as well.
So there's a couple of sticks, a couple of new sets of sticks in here that I'm really, really excited to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
If it's acceptable to be excited about talking about drumsticks.
Yeah. Take your pick. We've got four more pairs right there.
Yeah,
so.
Absolutely. Right. Well, I mean, let's start here because I'm closest to them.
Yeah.
These are absolute monsters. What can you say about this bad boy? Matt Halpern signature stick.
Yeah.
Ben, talk.
2B stick. Designed to feel like a 5B stick. Matt historically has played the Promark 2B.
Right.
Standard stick, but he just wanted something with a little bit more finesse, shall we say, but with the diameter, with the girth of a 2B.
Yeah.
You know? So
it's all about the girth, apparently.
This is basically his signature stick to his spec. And he's played about with the taper and the tip again, what we were covering with select balance, it changes the weight of the stick.
So, this stick, I suppose, if you wanted to break it down into the same way that we were talking about the others, would be a little bit more forward balanced.
Yeah, I mean, it's surprisingly though, although it's a short taper,
it's
surprisingly well balanced. It's kind of somewhere in the middle.
Okay.
Because Matt's playing style is massive, you know, big sort of tub thumping when he wants.
But he's all over the place.
All over the place, very fluid,
yeah.
But also plays, you know, with dynamics and a little finesse.
Massively,
shall we say.
Oh, massively, yeah.
So these sticks, although you might think, oh, 2B's far too big for me, they're actually a really well balanced stick.
Okay.
And I would really encourage anybody, even if you're not a fan of Matt Halpern, to come and try them out because they'll give you that bigger sound.
Yeah, if you prefer like a thicker piece of
wood in your hand,
this would be the stick to go for, I suppose.
It would.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Cool. All right, brilliant. And then
the other thing is his favourite Baltimore sports team colours.
Oh, okay.
So that's what the reference to the ink is.
Cool.
So check them out. He's really good on social media as well. So if you do get a pair of these, tag Matt in them
on Instagram.
Because
he'll probably come and say hello to you.
Because he's great at sharing these things.
Oh,
so
nice one.
Good brand ambassador.
Yeah, man.
Good lad.
Definitely, definitely. These beautiful things.
It's almost like the Bowie stick, isn't it?
Yeah, I love it.
It's not. It's the new Kimberly Thompson signature stick.
So tell me about Kimberly Thompson. Who is she?
Kimberly Thompson was famed for playing with Beyonce.
Okay.
So Beyonce always had the two drummers on stage, two female drummers. But Kimberly Thompson's actually a really active jazz cat. I think they're known as jazz cats. You know,
jazz cats.
In New York, jazz cats. She's been doing spots with Mike Stern. Massively, massively underrated drummer.
Yeah, so she's got all the chops.
All the chops, and does a lot of the gigging in the small New York clubs, you know, the places to be seen.
Yeah.
But the stick itself is something that I think Promark's range has probably been missing, which is a slightly longer 7A with a ball tip. So this is a stick really for playing much more intricate jazz kind of patterns on rides. If you want a lot of cymbal definition, generally the smaller ball tip will really define anything that's a bit more technical.
Yeah.
So possibly not one for the tub thumpers. Again, a small bead could potentially dent a head.
Yeah.
You know, if you're really giving
it
some.
Yeah.
But because it's got a longer taper on it, it gives you a lot more kind of rebound and response from the stick.
Yeah.
So longer than a 16 inch, and again, I'm going to reference it. Kimberly Thompson, it's 16 and a half with a 3.5 inch taper.
Cool.
So long stick, long taper.
Yeah, and it's probably also worth pointing out, it's only a minor detail, they're glittery.
This is the big thing. I was saved the best to last.
Yeah.
Basically, it's not active grip, it's just gold fleck in the lacquer. Now, I don't know if we can hold those up closer and get the light to kind of shine on them. We'll get a close-up as well.
Absolutely.
But embrace the gold, you know.
Oh, man, I love it. Seriously, if I had a signature stick, I'm now certain that they would be gold sparkle.
Why not?
Why not?
If you can, why not do it?
Exactly. Wow, pimp.
So, yeah, Kimberly Thompson. Check her out online as well, because she's got some great vids. Mm. Beast of a player.
Cool. And we've got some others to talk about, right?
Yeah, so these are much more orchestral, band, scholastic-orientated sticks. Mm-hmm. So it's the Concert 1s and 2s. We brought out the Concert 1s last year. They're basically designed for orchestral side drum playing, but I actually find they're great for rudiment practice.
Yeah.
So if you want a stick for a pad, these are much thicker, much, much longer. 0.645 diameter. So we're moving up.
Right.
Beyond 2B.
Yeah, absolutely.
Longer as well. So long taper. I think this is nearly 4 inches, if not 4, with a large oval tip. So it's really good stick for playing very subtle buzz rolls.
Yeah.
Because it's much more rear orientated.
Sure.
So you can play very, very subtly with these sticks. And you can get a big snare sound because of the contact point with the tip. The Concert 2s, these are really interesting. Again, 630 in diameter, so you've got like a 2B diameter stick, much longer. Mm. Longer taper, but we also taper the butt end of the stick.
Yeah, I noticed that before. That's a very, very, it feels really nice, actually. I've never thought about that before.
It kind of follows the contour of your, your hand, so like the pad of your hand there fits nicely. But by removing the material at the end of the stick, you kind of change the weight again. Mm. So it is... it is designed, again, to allow you to play subtly.
And again, for a heavier stick, they're really nice and light, aren't they? They're not super heavy.
No.
Not at all. I would imagine this would be a really good practice stick for me, for sure. You know, I definitely prefer to practice on a pad with bigger sticks. Mm-hmm. This has got the right kind of weight for me, I think.
Definitely. You know? But I think this stick, that stick you probably wouldn't want to play on a kit.
Yeah, oh yeah.
However, that I wouldn't...
You'd go
disregard playing on a drum kit.
Yeah, it's within the realms, isn't it? Definitely.
If you've got somebody who wants a super long stick, then.
I also like this sort of bronzy kind.
Yeah, it's a bit classier. Like,
well, they did that on the Neil Peart sticks as well, right?
Yeah.
There's a very similar colour. And
that sort of bronzed ink. Yeah, exactly right.
Like it, nice touch.
So, yeah, classy. And works with tweed as well.
Perfect. That's all you need in life.
So, yeah, those are the Concert 1s and 2s.
Brilliant.
Available now from all PMT outlets.
Super.
Definitely. Yeah. On the hipster vibe, the bronze vibe,
yeah,
that leads us onto the new stick bags.
Yeah, so they're sexy, these. Love them.
These were released this year. Transport Deluxe stick bag here, and the Sliver Essentials stick bag.
Sliver.
The Sliver.
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 Okay.
It's a bit of a tongue tie, but it's a sliver of a stick bag.
Yeah.
And sliver. It keeps your essentials in the bag.
Yeah, so you can just rock up to a show with just exactly what you need rather than the surplus. And
you can go in stealth. And you can have it down your leg, trouser leg. You could go in stealth. It only zips down to halfway.
Okay.
Because you really don't need to open it all the way, all the way up. And then you've got two different versions of contact. And so you can actually pop it on tension rods.
Yeah.
With this elasticated.
Oh, that's a really, really
band.
Cool idea.
Or the other one is the little handle has a hole in it, which allows you to hang it off a tension rod. So you can just pop it on like that.
Who is the ideas guy that came up with this? He needs a big handshake. That's a great idea.
Oh, this will be Elijah over in the States. Well, now, Elijah's great. He kind of oversees a lot of the Promark product
design. I've never seen
this
done before. Like, what a simple, basic idea, but what a cool idea.
Little design.
Very cool.
Little design thing.
Very, very cool.
Things that drummers need.
Yes, absolutely. Obviously,
with your kind of veggie leather style.
Yeah, I was
going
to say leatherette.
Leatherette, veggie leather.
Pleather.
And the little Didario logo on the inside.
Cool, man,
so,
nice.
Stealth, lovely. Like this one.
Yeah, I dig.
The big brother version of is the Transport Deluxe stick bag. So again, it's hipsterfied.
Mm-hmm.
Nice kind of, I don't know, khaki. Khaki colour.
Khaki, yeah.
The best feature on this bag. Watch this.
Oh, magnets. Magnets. Oh, man, everyone needs magnets in their life.
Just the little
We've got
touch.
Some more magnets to talk about in a little while as well, haven't we?
Oh, yeah, we have some more magnets.
Absolutely.
Magnets.
I wonder if they're not the same magnets, are they?
I wish. Honestly. Right, so front pocket. And he's got a nice little face as well. Can you see him?
Yeah. Hey, buddy. You all right?
Pretty cool. But that's all your essential stuff. You might want to put a cloth, a pair of magician's gloves, whatever you like, inside the accessory.
Cool. And you've got, obviously, the standard sort of shoulder strap, all adjustable. Again, the same system that we were talking about before with the elastic that will fit onto your floor tom.
Yeah.
Tension rods.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I mean, it needs that one, obviously, with it being a bit bigger,
course,
a bit
yeah.
more weight.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
really only want to hang that from the tension rods.
Definitely.
Internally, you've got an accessory pocket, so again, you might want to pop a drum key in there, business cards, sticks. This is a really nice touch. This is your favourite pair slot.
Oh, so very nice.
They've put the leather down.
Cool.
Your favourite pair slot.
Yes.
So you're giving them extra attention.
Yeah. It's all about that, isn't it?
It is.
Little details.
Little details.
Yeah.
Accessory pocket, you can pop your phone in there, your wallet. Pen, you know, the essential items, you can hang a drum key off there. That the bag doesn't come with the key, but that would be the add-on accessory, I'd say.
Right, okay. Yeah, right.
So yeah, essentials.
Does it come with the key? Does it come with the little leather holder for the key?
The key does. So
we
now have right. these available.
So that's another one of your products?
Another one of the products.
Okay.
So it's basic drum key in the tackle style. holder.
Nice.
And it all matches.
Beautiful.
Fantastic. So Sliver Essentials, Transport, Deluxe.
Nice one. Thank you, Ben.
It's fine. It's all right.
That's all right. Thank you so much for joining us today. It's been really, really informative. Thank you for coming down, Ben. Really, really appreciate it.
It's been great fun.
Yeah, if you've got any further questions or if you need to know anything about any of the products we've just spoke about today, www.pmtonline.co.uk. You can also hit us up on any of our social media channels. So we've got our Facebook, PMT House of Drums, Twitter, PMT House of Drums, and finally Instagram, PMT House of Drums. Thank you so much.
Cheers.